Guys, and welcome back here again. I want to say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on where you are watching from. Thanks for stopping by here again today. It's your girl, as you know, Miss Continental. So guys, hey, they say stupidity will never stop. Stupidity will never cease to exist, guys. You know what? I'm laughing. You guys know why I'm laughing? It's so funny, okay? This is so funny. Anyways, I'm just gonna play this video, okay? Because I can't explain, but I will just play a little segment of this video that I'm gonna talk about, and then una go understand the kind mumu when these people be. When I mean mumu of this century, mumu of those days, they still they get sense, but the mumu of these days, they the mumu well. Okay, global mumu. So you guys just wait. It's two of them. They are not couples, though. But this kind of people, they would be so good to be a couple, because now the same mumu, now they get different mumu. They some mumu they will be say, as the 1+1, though they look you like this. Remove this thing from there. Remove that shoe. Put them up there. They will do the opposite. That one they have some. But this kind of mumu now, they have the same thing in common. And it's so unfortunate that these people, they come through the continent we call Nigeria. They were both born in Nigeria, but they live in the UK. Me, I don't know whether not everybody living in the UK. Please, no disrespect to my gorgeous Nigerian people living in the UK. Okay? But these two people I want to talk about today now, we shift the focus to UK. So, not be my fault. Now, what is some of your people, some of your Nigerian, they are not Nigerian anymore, anyways. Some adopted British citizens from Nigeria. Now, what did they do? Now, make me bring this matter come up. Now, they bring now. Like, if anything, you should blame them, not me. Okay? So, guys, watch this clips. Then I will be back with the rest of my thoughts, and I will let you know exactly why I classify these people in the mumu category.
They put up that challenge to me, that if I'm not comfortable, why don't I burn my Nigerian passport on the social media? Nigeria has done nothing for me. I don't owe Nigeria anything. The only thing that Nigeria has done for me is perhaps my parents being Nigerian. I have offended anybody for destroying that passport by burning it live on Facebook. You know what? As a gentleman, I render an apology. Something. I have always been a British, and I'm proud to be a British, and I will continue to be proud to be a British. And let me tell you, God bless the British government. God bless Her Majesty. This is my British passport, and I kiss it. Again. That takes me anywhere, and I'm proud.
Guys, share. What do you guys think about this man? I don't know where to start from, but I just feel sorry for his wife. I'm sure he's married. And I feel sorry for his children, if he has any. And I'm sure he does. I can tell you this man is has some mental problems. I'm not a psychiatrist, but I can easily tell you. A man of his age. We're not talking about teenagers who they think the system has failed them in Nigeria. We're not talking about an adult, for heaven's, for crying out loud. I mean, they said a fool at 40 is a fool forever. Forever and ever. He's above 40, men looking at him. He took his Nigerian passport, like he said, from the horse's mouth, you guys heard him, and burnt it because nothing is working well at this age. If a 20 years old can do that, a 25 years old, a man of 45 or maybe in his 50s, what is he looking for? Even people in Nigeria self. You in UK abroad, you took the passport. God bless the queen. My people, Mona, reason this thing with me. Maybe not, but I said they say this matter. All these kind people, now it be that they accuse of treasonable felony, not be showery. These kind people, just ordinary passport that you have. You do, God bless the queen. God bless. My people wanna ask me, person they see, because they see good woman outside. Like somebody treats you well as a woman, or maybe teacher, you have a teacher that you look up to, a role model, and then you disown your mother. And you say your mother is not it again. Maybe because your mother is poor, cannot afford you stuff, and then you find a rich woman outside who is treating you like a child. And then you automatically disown your mother. And then you choose that, you now proclaim the so-called woman outside that is treating you as your mother. Like, I don't know how to explain this. Like, I'm so short of words. Like, what has this man to say to his children? I want to believe that this man is not married, though. Honestly, I just want to believe it, because if he's married and his wife knows this, and they're still, let me say, the woman herself is still sick. The woman is still sick. And the funny part of it is that he said somebody dared him. Young man, it's my prayer that you find this video. You are a proverbial disgrace. A proverbial one. Real one. In short, Nigeria doesn't even want you. We don't want you in that country. No, go take visa. I beg all high commissioners, Nigerian high commissioners abroad in the diaspora, I'm going to mark this man. Anywhere he appear, he want a visa. May they not give out to Nigeria, because even with his British passport, he can still obtain a visa and go to Nigeria. Every day, boy, Nigerian passport. Of course, you cannot go and seek Nigerian passport anywhere now. They're not going to give you for sure. But if you want to go seek visa, visa too, you know what? Okay. Now, there you go, die, put, bury you, put. And this is what we are talking about. Your children. Definitely, you are a second-class citizen. No matter how you feel, say, you get work. And I'm saying this without no apology to, do I say Africans? Including myself. I don't want to use the entire black race. I want to say Africans. You are living in the Western world. You like me, you get PhD up or PhD or PhD. You are still second-class citizen. You are still second-class citizen. And even your children, when you born here, self, you know, they classroom with other, I'm not sounding racist here, but I mean, let's say the truth, okay? Buy the truth and sell it. No, this is just the truth. We are crying the days of slavery, the years that we wasted in slavery. And there are still some people who are voluntarily giving themselves into slavery. Not just giving themselves into slavery, even their children. Tell me now, this one now, you know they go Nigeria again. According to him, he has nothing to do with Nigeria. He burned his passport, his children saw it. What message is he giving to the children? Automatically, the children, their roots don't finish. You know they exist again. Now you cannot dare finish. Their children. So I don't know how to say this. But picking on the seafood when it's sweet for mouth, eat. You go come to say in mama food they smell. It's not done anywhere. This is complete what Yoruba people we call omwale. And I'm sure this guy is a Yoruba guy. Omwale gidi gidi disgrace. And he says somebody dared him. He want to cobalize the person, go call the person in. Oga, you don't get any that the guy's name that you called. It's not the problem. You are the problem. You are a fool. Okay, now he dared you. Now I dared you to set yourself ablaze. Go ahead. Since you are a fool, anybody can dare you. Come on, guys. We teach our children for them not to be dared by other friends to do silly stuff. We all know teenagers, adolescents, how they dare each other. Oh, I dare you to do this. I dare you to pull up your pants. I dare you to run into the snow without shoes. They play with all these things. And you are saying somebody dared you to burn your passport on Facebook. Now make it go. You be mumu. Nigeria. Don't even let people know that you originate from. You said the only thing Nigeria have done for you is that they bettered your parents. Did your parents deny being in Nigeria, being Nigerians? The only thing Nigeria did for you is they bettered your parents. You appreciate that. Now tell me, will your parents be proud of you? Let's assume they are alive. Will they be proud of you now, what you did? Even let's assume they are no more. They've gone to glory. Will they be happy with you there? What you did, Mr. Man? Come on, guys. Again, this brings us to the issue of Nigeria. How people tend to over-magnify, over-represent the situation in Nigeria. I know people who are in Nigeria, they say Nigeria is good, Nigeria is this, Nigeria is this. The only thing, the number one thing, if we are to be having light every day in Nigeria, say for example, we are to be having light, nobody will be abroad here now. Nobody go there here. Nigeria, we have it all. It's so unfortunate. Leadership is a very serious matter. If leadership is so easy, we're not going to see broken families and divorce homes where the father cannot take full responsibility and function. I mean, make the family function properly. If it's that easy, just a family of a family of four, a family of three. You know, sometimes how difficult it is even to keep them intact. Not to talk of a federation like Nigeria. They were blaming people. It's not easy. Leadership is not easy. Even our, some of our people now give them supervisor position. Make their supervisor make 3-4 people deal under them. They go get issues. If you are a man, you don't even fit take care of a family. You don't fit function in a family. And you they complain about a whole leader of a federation. It starts with the family unit. If you have failed your own family, one way or the other, seal your mouth. Don't even complain about the country Nigeria. Don't complain. Okay? Don't complain. We complain about everything. We complain about man, we complain about woman. Woman will complain about man. They will complain about pastor. Let's talk about pastor. We'll come to that someday. Complain about teacher. Complain about this. Everything is just complain. When we know when woman they born so girl. You know, girl boy, let me, for the benefit of those who are not Nigerians, who doesn't understand pidgin, you keep complaining, blaming everybody. Like I always like to say, a lazy man quarrels with his tools. You are a man, you are married. You are not able to have female children. You blame it on the government. You are not able to have male children. You blame it on the government. At night, if the thing don't stand well, you go blame the government. If your wife no cook food, everything is just blame. Look at this one now. You did UK now. You are surviving there, babe. You are kissing your passport. You said thank God to the British government. You kiss the so okay. What in Nigeria can do, you know? When he started, I thought he was going to say they burnt his house down, they seized his property. I was trying to listen. I listened to the video back and forth. I was trying to see a particular segment of the video where he would refer to what Nigeria actually did to him. What the government, what happened to him? He said they failed him. Things are not working. Are you the only one in the country? Are you the only one in the country? Why must you bring your stupidity outside there for people to see? And you did it, fine, and then you are coming out to the open to say you are so, I mean, what's the point of that? It really shows that you don't know what you are doing, man. You don't know what you are doing. We don't need you to come and talk about it. We don't need it. You've done it. Who do you owe an apology? Who you owe apology? Your apology is not needed. And you don't need to come and explain. We don't need your explanation. You are already an outcast. Take it like that. You are a bastard. Take it like that. Stupid gold. I know gold digger even better pass yourself. I don't know what I will call you. The same British. Don't even let me open my mouth at all. This man, honestly, I don't know what to say. I don't want to say too much because I don't want to waste my time, you know, dwelling on your issue. But I just wanted to show it to the world how stupid you are, that stupid people like you still exist. If you read your history very well, if you know history very well, You will not come here and start kissing the queen and start kissing the passport and start denouncing your country, burning your passport, your Nigerian passport, your birth country, where you have full rights to be voted for, where you can even wake up tomorrow and say you want to be president of Nigeria. Yeah? Yes, you can do that. You're not the president because you were born there, you have your ties there. Then you are coming here to say all sort of nonsense. You know, if you know history very well, okay, you will know what this your people, British, did those days. Your forefathers and years of slavery and everything. Then you are coming here. Let me tell you, all that they took, now the peanut of it, the benefit peanut, now they put for your mouth. When they eat, when they sweet for your mouth, they call you, no, you be moale, you be nonsense, rubbish man. I don't want to waste my time talking about you. You are foolish. A man like these people, and there are men like that out there. Just go another woman's house, visit outside, go to party, visit people, cook for them, ukodo, correct food. You see, when they eat and finish, they will forget that they get family for house. Now this man typify for this video. Now that kind of man, this is the kind of man that would denounce his wife, denounce his children, denounce everything about his family after eating good food outside. This is the kind of man that will do it. Foolish man. Next, Jare, another mumu again. What I want to talk about. Where is her face? Uh-huh. Put her there.
This is what I have.
This face, another foolish woman. Goodness, that's not plenty for UK. Did you see this video? When this woman started, hey, Chris, Inene. I remember when I was obtaining my Canadian passport. I'm not saying I'm a saint, too, but I could still remember vividly. Then you don't have to write an exam or anything. I know it's a little bit difficult now. Then you just need to stand up and sing the national anthem. And what I was always used to was Arise, O compatriots, Nigeria, call, obey. That was what I was always used to. But in this case, I was asked to sing the Canadian national anthem. Not just me, myself and other group of people. So, and I know there were some officials washing our mouth, you know, how we are saying it, if we are saying it right. And when I got to that place where it says my home and native land, I was actually in tears. I struggled with those lines. My home and native land. Of course, I do have my native land, which is Nigeria. And Isho, I think at this point, I'm starting to think that I can understand why Showera didn't go for the American passport, because I understand he has his green card, but he doesn't have the passport. I can understand why. And I want to say, I want to use the opportunity to say that any presidential candidate or any person, any Nigerian citizen who wants to vie for like a government position, like any political position, and has a citizen, dual citizen somewhere, I think people like that should not even be allowed to hold a political position or any government position in the country Nigeria. You know why I say this? Because before they become a citizen, there's an oath of allegiance. I will call it the national anthem. It's a very serious thing. You don't just sing it and you think, you know, an ordinary song will just talk. I see that as an oath. I take it very seriously. And that's why during their games, you know, they are made to sing it. Like, you know what? It's a vow. It's an oath that they are taking. So after you travel to UK, you become a UK citizen, you become American citizen and all that, you take all that out, and then you are coming back to Nigeria again and you want to hold a position. I think at this point, you know, seeing what is happening now, that is what I will say, okay? I think at this point they should legislate it, that if you have a dual citizen, you're a citizen of another country, you've traveled out of Nigeria, you've gone to get a citizen of another, you are coming back, you should not be allowed to hold any political or any political position in the country. That's what I would say, because I was crying and looking back now, looking at these idiots, how they are worshiping. Now, never see place when we say, you be citizen of a country, America, UK, what citizen, let's put it that way, but they are wasting in jail. Is it the citizen that makes you somebody? It's not the citizen that makes you somebody. Yes, it is true. Like this Momoge now said, you can now travel everywhere, eh? Traveling all over the country, what do you want to bring you? What do you want to bring you? See the way she started, when she was crying, I felt so bad. I said, I want to see, why is this girl, come, passport, this one. Hey, Jesus, Nigerians, why would they do like this now? What do you reach like this? It's a passport. You have it, congratulations, rejoice. Don't bring it to our face here and rub it to our face. There are people in Nigeria your age, women, okay, you say you are married. Because I had an opportunity to listen to everything that she said. Like I said, there's no space to play everything here, no one is listening by herself. Because she said she's married, she has children, you can even see her ring. There are women like you, your age in Nigeria, married with children. They have not even gone to Muhammad Mohammed, but they live better than you are living in that UK. If you even come to Nigeria self, you will still be their maid again. She, you say you were a maid before. You will still be their maid. You'll be happy to be their maid. They've not stepped out of that country. Say anything abroad, then they can't even stand it. The passport now, it won't give you billions. Let me tell you, if you're in Nigeria, you are rich, you have your money, you can travel any country in the world and come back to your tent back there in Nigeria. So what? What is the big deal? Are we the only? I mean, are Nigerians the only British citizens in the UK? Are we the only ones? Why it be so our things they different? Why it be so? We don't have to do this now. We don't have to. Trust me, there are some countries in Africa that are worse than Nigeria. Let me tell you, they are. But because of their national interest, the keen interest they have in their country to hide, to keep their dirty laundry, they know they come out, they know they do all these things, when they do so. See that man, passport, paper, agbaya, giddy, giddy. And then this one come now, get friends. He say, this, he? God, I be enough fit talk, Jare. It's just a passport, madam. This one will not take you to heaven. It will not give you all the riches. It will not change you from the second class citizen when you be from Britain. Mm-hmm. Like I want to, like I normally say, you're a second class citizen. Even your children themselves, in classroom, in schools, everything, they have to do like triple, double their counterparts. I don't want to call their name here. To be like, they have to do double of what they are doing. They have to be really exceedingly good. Not be push me, I push you. They have to be really, really good. Because they... So what did I want to do? Is it not passport? Some people are not free to talk, Jerry. Our mumu don't do. All this kind of news, as if I just see them for YouTube. But I would just tire. Idiots. Guys, let's end this broadcast here today, Jerry. I beg. If we travel abroad, whatever we're able to get out of it, let's cherish it. Let's give God the glory. And let's not just act like that is the end of the world. Some people travel abroad, they don't get paper one day. They manage, work money where they want to work, buy their ticket, deport themselves, go Nigeria, go establish. What do you have to say about those kind of people? I remember one man like that. I think I was fairly new in the country then. He was actually a manager in Nigeria in the water board. For those of also are very familiar with Benin City water board, like Lawani area, that water board. He said he was their manager there at water board. So for some reason he left his position. He came to Canada. When he entered the society here in Canada, the court, I call it secret court, because once you enter, it takes grace of God to come out. He see the system. He regretted waiting make her leave the country. Do you know what he did? We used to call him Epa. For those of you who were very close to Epa, I know a few people who might probably stumble into this video will understand what I'm talking about. He rented a basement apartment. And he was working himself out day and night. He said the money that he used to come to Canada, the money that he will need to establish in Nigeria, that is what he's working for. And immediately he got his ticket money, the money, the things that he sold, borrowed or whatever, how he came, and also made the money that he needed to establish himself when he got to Nigeria. I think all this time, it took about a year and a half, 6 months. He went back to Nigeria. Behold, people that were his landlord here, remember I told you he rented a basement apartment, right? So he had Nigerian landlords. When he finally returned to Nigeria to go and establish, his landlords here, when they visited Nigeria to go and look for, they couldn't see him. When they went to the park, because when he got to Nigeria, he bought a big plot, vast area like that, and he used it as a motor park. When they came there, they say, our guy no deal. I think the guy said he went there twice to go and look for a park. He couldn't find him. He no Christian, because he was too busy. His boys, they take them, sit down. But this one, people who come from Canada, come look for a person, bought them drinks twice, like they couldn't see him. Because the level don't to go high, don't to go far. When he was leaving, we said, ah, Epa, at least you for stay, try to get the paper so that you can invite the children. He said, my children are not coming to this place. No, they're not coming to this place. What of your paper? At least try to get your paper. So he said, no, I don't need it. He left. Within 2 years, he was work. He was working. He went back. Yes, that's what he wanted. So you, when you get passport, they tantalize and they cry. Don't use it to go and convince people or make people believe that is the end of the world. Because your own situation, the long throat, when it make you stay UK and won't make you die for UK, it's not another person's problem. Do you understand? More on they use all these things. This more on they create all this kind of idea to people that once you have a passport, once you have once you have a passport in the Western world, then you are made for life. No more use and they deceive people. That is my own. It's pure deception. People in Nigeria, they are watching you. They say he na red passport, be that one. No, man, I don't use that to deceive people. You have it, keep it, because your own problem, what is pursuing you back home, and what's making you stay in UK is different from what will bring somebody to UK. Do you understand? One man's problem is another man's joy. Eh? The problem when you get now is somebody get, and that one will be joy. Another person's problem go be your own joy. So your own situation is different from the other situation. So stop coming to social media and start advertising rubbish. Nonsense. Useless people. Mumu. And a verse, guys. Okay, I'm just going to end this broadcast here today, guys. Guys, I'm just being myself. Okay? And as you know, I'm a learner. But out of every nonsense, there's always a sense to make out of it. When we come this abroad, we shouldn't think that's the end of the world. We are supposed to be visiting abroad to come and, you know, greener pastures or whatever. Who is here to study? You are here to study. Different reason, either economic, political, education, anything that brings you here, go after it. And then once you're satisfied, go back home. At the end of the day, here is no home. Here is not your native land. As I was made to sing, my home and native land. I have my home and native land. We are all sojourners here. Yeah? Let's not just, lose our mind over it because we are here. Then we are on top of the world. Nigeria will be okay someday. At least there was one time that our currency was even higher than the pound. And it's going to come to that again. Okay? So guys, now here I talk and reach to do. Thanks for watching, guys. Okay? If you like this video, don't fail to give it a thumbs up. And feel free to leave your comments in the section down below. Okay, until I come your way again, I continue to remain your girl, Miss Continental. It's bye for now.